show 6.
We have a great show for you today, filled with Step Up Day, Cafeteria, and Water Polo.
And first up, Step Up Day with the amazing 2017 candidates.
What do we say? No more dresses in this army.
You want it, sir?
No!
Bummer, probably won't see a single one of them.
Shucks, at least you have me.
Yeah, okay.
Next up, food. And not just any food, cafeteria food.
The cafeteria, where in movies and TV shows, the one place students don't want to go because of their gross lunches? Not this place. In here, our students rush to the line to get the food made by Bavaria's Alliance.
As you know, it's used to it. But now it's usually like random. You know, we kind of see what you guys like. On a certain day, we have certain things, includes the weather. We also choose what we buy. But yeah, it's mostly random-ish, yeah. every day we do some kind of food like quesadillas, cheese quesadillas, chicken tenders, french fries. That's what we usually do every day besides what we do with the other kind of menu.
Is there any other way to pay besides cash?
Besides cash, the students can also pay with credit cards or with a debit card, or also with a gift card, which we supply them. If they pay us first, the money can be cash or check, and then we give them a gift card, and they can use it like every day.
What do you think about the food that they serve here?
The food's pretty good. It's a good meal, nutritious.
How much money do you spend here a day?
Probably about like $5 a day, not much. Try to keep it conservative.
What do you buy at home in the kitchen?
Diet Coke.
Okay. What would you rate this food out of it? 10 fries.
I would say 9 fries.
9 fries out of 10?
Yep.
I'm so hungry.
Tyler, you eat Twinkies?
Do I look like I make that much bank?
I bet water polo players don't eat Twinkies. Speaking of water polo, let's go to some highlights.
It's a lot of fun. I think it's a lot of hard work. Sometimes, you know, we're doing morning lifting or morning swimming. A lot of you guys don't see the workouts we do over the summer, where we train for about 3-4 hours a day over the summer, early mornings. So it's hard work, but it's also a lot of fun. We work real hard, and then, you know, I get opportunities to get in the water with the guys and kind of mess around a little bit there too. So overall, it's a lot of fun and a lot of hard work. What does it take? A lot of dedication. Like I said, it's a lot of early hours, long hours in the pool, and a lot of swimming. I mean, there'll be days we swim 10, 11, 12,000 yards in one practice. So a lot of dedication, a lot of hard work, and a lot of mental toughness to be able to go through those workouts and not quit on your teammates. I've been coaching water polo for about 8 or 9 years now. I started coaching kind of just as a college job on the side for club teams and assisting at my old high school, and then kind of got serious about it in about 2006, 2007, coaching for Gora High School and we won a CIF title there, and then, you know, ended up here and things are going well. Over the past 2 years, we've gone, I think, a total of 25 and 26, so we're about 500, and hopefully going to improve on that. Yeah, I played water polo in high school, at Thousand Oaks High School, and I also played at Pepperdine University. I played for a club team called Los Angeles Water Polo Club, which I now coach for as well, going to Junior Olympics and a lot of core work, I'd say, if you're, you know, lifting weights and things like that, shoulder work for the swimming, core exercises for your core strength, and then obviously legs to be able to tread water and stay afloat a lot. Other sports, obviously swim team would be the first one. And then again, just being an overall athlete helps in any sport. So if you're, you know, a basketball player or a baseball player or any other sport for that matter, I don't think it's going to be a detriment to you, but obviously swimming would be the top sport to help you in your water polo game.
We'd like to thank Mr. Delgado for a great season and being a great head coach for these boys.
Well, I'm Justin.
And I'm Tyler. Stay tuned for show 7, when we have Christmas at Crespi, basketball introduction, and an interview with the new president, Father Tom Batsis.